Now to new warnings on our energy prices, with already spiking costs expected to worsen in the coming months. Nine Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards is in Canberra for us. Eliza, good morning. Summer will heat up power bills.
Yes, Sarah, that's the expectation from the energy regulator, which has revised up its estimates for power prices for early next year. With an El Niño system set to bring stronger than usual summer heat waves, people will be reaching for the aircon to stay cool. This year, we saw a jump in wholesale electricity and gas prices in the 3 months to June. This is what energy retailers pay before passing the costs on to household power bills. The departure of the Liddell coal-fired power station was partly to blame for the rise, but the good news is the increases remained well below the crisis levels we saw this time a year ago. But with more price pressures on the way, Labor's pre-election promise of power bill cuts by 2025 is slipping further and further from view. Sarah.
Thanks, Eliza. Right, let's move on now. More power price pain is set to hit households in the coming months as an El Niño forecast looms. Jane, wholesale electricity prices are already spiking. The summer outlook, well, it's quite bleak.
Well, and that $275 off your energy bill promise does seem to be a long way in the rear vision mirror now. Mm. We've just heard that in New South Wales alone, the average price rise on an energy bill is around $430. In Victoria, it's around $350. That's an enormous imposition. Yesterday, it was reported that more than 50% Australians would struggle if they got a surprise bill that they weren't expecting. That's a real concern. The cost of living is skyrocketing out of control, and it doesn't matter whether it's energy prices or grocery prices or mortgage or rent. Inflation keeps pushing up the price of everything, and the only way to get the cost of living sustainably under control is to get inflation under control. We can't leave all of that to the Reserve Bank. The government has to do its share too. And in the energy sector, the policy decisions that the government is making, whether it be safeguard mechanisms or price caps or new taxes, are actually pushing new energy sources out of the system. It's deterring new investment. Okay. The only way you're going to be able to bring down energy prices is if you increase supply and encourage new investment.
I mean, Sophie, we know that obviously there are global contributing factors here. I guess that $275 that Jane pointed out really won't necessarily make a dent in the cost of living crisis for a lot of Australians. But what more can the government do? It's a tricky one.
No. Yeah, it is. And you're absolutely spot on. I think actually you'd probably be hard pressed to find somebody whose bill hasn't gone up by more than $275. And if it hasn't, it probably will. I think the broader issue too here, and Jane would be better placed to be able to answer it, is that we have such a complex system. If you can find somebody who can explain to me the way that energy regulation works in this country in a way that makes sense, I would really love to hear from them. You know, it is so complex and it's so different. And it's also really different across the country. I mean, those wholesale prices vary so differently from state to state. So I do think that more broadly it should be something that is looked at. I do think we should be turning to government to not only make sense of it, but also to be sure that any sort of transition that's being spoken about is being done in a way that is sustainable and is not going to cost even more to those of us who are already struggling. And Jane mentioned those people who, if there was a bill to pop up tomorrow, they wouldn't be able to pay it. I think you'll find that that percentage is only going to increase over the short term rather than get better.
Yeah, absolutely. It is a bit tough out there, guys. All right, well, hopefully the Matildas will deliver a win tonight and make it all better. Thanks so much for joining us today.